Assalamu alaikum. Today we're looking at a road map, okay? So, but it's a road map without a grid reference. You remember we did a grid reference where you have blocks and then they name the blocks on the top and on the side, right? So today's map is a road map, but there's no grid reference, so you're not looking for a grid and then placing a town in a grid somewhere, okay? This is a road map. You can see that's also a bar scale there, but we're not doing calculations on the bar scale for this map. What we're looking for is to get directions from one place to another. So if this is somewhere in the Cape, it's along the coast, and you can see it's showing you all the street names, and it has a few symbols here. And if we look on the chart, okay, the information says that if you see a small I, this is where you can get information. Usually in these holiday destinations, you would find this. Then if you're looking for a hotel or a place to eat or something, they would give you all the information. If you can see here, it's pointing to where the information place is. Then A stands for accommodation. So you can see it's obviously a holiday, a tourist place. So there's A here, A there. You can see along the coast everywhere, A there. Okay, here's another A, here's another A. So it would be all different hotels or bed and breakfasts and so forth, right? Then H is showing you where the hotels are. So there's the H there. There's another H there. You can see there along the coast if you're looking for your hotel. And then the blue mark would be the police station. So if we look for the police station, there's the police station. That's the post office. This is a place of worship. So if you're looking for a church, then you would look for the place of worship on the map. Okay, this is the hospital. If something happens on your holiday, you need to look for a hospital. And places of interest would be obviously tourist destinations where you would want to go as a tourist, and all the scenery and so forth, right? So if we look at this map, one of the important things is the compass. Can you see the compass here? Obviously, you need to know your direction. So when they give you a compass, they will point towards north, right? So you can see in this one here, north is here. So you have to know that north, south is at the bottom, and east is that way, and west is this way. You have to know those. You have to know your directions, and you have to be able to read those directions off the map. Okay, and then as you can see here, can you see the main roads sometimes have a color here? So you can see this one is showing to Cape Town, or it's also called main road, but it's normally one of the highways or the important roads that are going to this one is going to Cape Town, and these would be streets. Okay, so these ones are all street names. This Mitchell Street, Late Street, Magnolia Street, Patterson Street, these are all names of streets. So it's actually a road map. So the kind of questions that you would see on a map like this here, look, we're not concentrating on the bar scale and measurement. We're concentrating today on a street map, okay? So this is a street map. And if you need to give, say, for instance, somebody comes to you and you had information here, and if you need to give them directions how to get to the Old Harbor Museum, you have to tell him how to go if he's traveling by car, which road to take, where to turn left into which road, where to turn right into which road, follow the main road, turn left into Harbor Road, carry on, follow the bend, and then you'll see it on your left-hand side, those kind of directions. So again, it's very logical. Each question is different. You just have to know how to read a map. If you practice one map, you should be okay to answer all the questions. Only thing you need to bear in mind that this is a street map, okay? It's called a street map, and also there's no grid reference like the ones we had before, where you see a grid and then it tells you look in D4 for a certain place, right? Now we're looking for directions from one position to another position, and how you going to direct that person using streets. Okay, here's the compass, and then the compass is also very important. And if you had a question on bar scales, then there's your bar scale representing the distances. Okay, so this one is showing you 600 yards, so we don't work in yards, but then this one is just a map bar scale to show you that how many centimeters would be equal to 600 yards. Okay, so then you're going to use the questions. I'm not going through these questions here. It's for you to read through the questions and answer the questions on the street map.